Mozart died 225 years ago tomorrow, on December 5th, 1791, leaving unfinished at his death the work that we're performing for you tonight. And that fact sort of spawned all sorts of theories. Conspiracy theories that Mozart had been poisoned by a jealous rival, that the dark, cloaked, and masked deliverer of the commission to his door had been a harbinger of death, that he was composing his own requiem, all sorts of theories going on that led to this work in its condition at that point. We actually know a fair amount about Mozart's schedule and his life over the last couple of months. He received the commission from an eccentric Viennese nobleman in July of 1791 for a requiem to be used for the nobleman's dead wife. It's quite likely that the nobleman expected to pass the work off as his own, as he had done with other composers' compositions. Mozart, about that same time, had a commission to compose an entire opera for the coronation of a new king of Bohemia, which he took and went to Prague in early September, I think, to have the premiere of that opera. At the end of September, he finished up The Magic Flute, which had its premiere at the end of that month. That was a big hit. He performed some of the performances of that opera. He composed the clarinet concerto early in October, a couple of other pieces, and finally, somewhere in October, got down to working on the Requiem Commission. On the 20th of November, he fell ill, took to his bed, and lasted for 3 more weeks. It is known from the manuscripts that he composed and orchestrated the entire first movement, most of the choruses and the bass lines, through the first 8 measures of the Lacrimosa, and then some of the Domine Jesu, and a little bit of the rest of the piece. His copyist, Franz Zeismeyer, as he seems to have pronounced it, was ultimately chosen by Mozart's wife to finish up the Requiem, and polished it off in quite quick order. He may not have been a composer of Mozart's stature, but he certainly knew enough to complete the Requiem on command, and that is the version that has basically come down to us that is still the most popular. More than a dozen scholars have quibbled with this. They've sort of thrown out some things that Zeismeyer wrote, reorchestrated. There have been other manuscripts that have come to light that they decided were the real ideas for the Requiem, and they've made those into alternative versions. None of those have quite stuck as this one has. I think most likely because Zeismeyer and Mozart had an excellent working relationship. Zeismeyer was a trained composer, and he was an 18th century composer, and what he wrote for this Requiem, which hangs together pretty well, I think makes a lot of sense still for this piece. I hope you will take this performance not only as the performance of a beautiful piece of music, but as an opportunity to reflect and to remember those people in your life who have gone before, who you were dedicated to, family members, friends, colleagues, and to just remember them and the best parts of their lives as well. I want to thank Dr. Kathy Roma for providing the orchestral parts that we're playing from tonight, and also to wish you the best of holidays upcoming. So thank you again for being here tonight.
Thank you. all